So this learning cycle is how we're getting information to our brain, but your brain's taking in a lot of information all at the same time from all of the sensory systems. So you can see and hear and touch and taste and smell and get information from your body all the time that may not be relevant. So I might be in a cafeteria and there's hundreds of people talking. Well, my brain doesn't care what they're talking about because I'm not part of their conversations. My brain cares about when someone walks up and says my name. That matters. That's an important sensation. So not only does our brain have to interpret sensations correctly, it also has to filter sensations correctly. We have to say, I can ignore this, I need to pay attention to this. And that's what we see with a lot of kids with sensory processing difficulties. And the thing that we probably talk about the most is this inability to filter correctly. We call it sensory modulation. So that's when we talk about, oh, they're tactilely defensive or they're oversensitive to this thing. That's what we're talking about, that their brain is not able to correctly filter out and pay attention to the correct sensations. They're maybe oversensitive or undersensitive. When we see the kids that are oversensitive, that's a lot of the kids who are having meltdowns really easily. They're maybe covering their ears. They hate the lights to be on. They hate it when you touch them or when their clothing touches them or when they have to touch anything messy. Those are all examples of oversensitivity to sensory information. And it means their brain isn't able to block out all of that information coming in. And so they just get overwhelmed because it's too much to pay attention to. Then you see our kids that are under responsive or they're not sensitive enough. They're the kids that you say their name like 10 times in a row before they say, oh, you're talking to me. Or you maybe repeat their name 10 times and they never look at you because their brain is not able to say that's an important sensation. It's just paying attention to everything all at the same time. So a child with autism can get very easily overwhelmed. They are taking in this whole floodgate of sensory information and they don't know what to do with it. And I like to compare it to like when you have a headache. All of us have times when our sensory system is not working correctly. So I always like to, if I'm trying to figure out what a child is doing, I think, when is that most like this time in my life? What in my life relates to this? So when I think of kids that are getting overwhelmed by sensation, I think of when I have a headache. I don't want anyone to talk to me. I want the lights off. I just want to curl up under a blanket and just be completely isolated. And even the smallest little noise can be overwhelming and it makes your head hurt. So I don't think by any means that children with autism have headaches all the time, but they're more easily in that state where even a small sensation can seem very big and be very overwhelming. Or I think about with our kids who are under responsive, I think about when I first wake up in the morning, how my body feels. You know, you wanna do a big stretch and you just like need a little time to get going. Maybe you're a coffee drinker, maybe you're a morning yoga person. We take a little time to amp up our bodies and to get going for the day. But some of our kids with autism feel like that all day long. And they need, that's why they're running and crashing into things, because they need their morning yoga all day long and they don't know how to get what they need, so they just go crazy. So a lot of these things that kids with autism are doing, it's not just random movement, they're fulfilling a need. And I like to think about, well, have I ever done anything like that? It may not be as extreme as what they're doing, it may not be as frequently as what they're doing, but I'd say at least 90% of the time, we've all done something similar that we can relate to. And when we can kind of make that click, we say, oh, that's the need they have, then we know how to move forward and help them.